What's going on, y'all? Welcome to the Single Guy channel. My name is Lloyd. I am not the single guy. Today we're going to be talking about 11 green flags to look for when you're dating a woman. Now, we've already covered the negative side of this, which is 10 red flags to watch out for when you're dating somebody. Now, this is going to be the positive version, which is if you see these signs in a woman, you should probably date her. It doesn't mean you two are going to be soulmates, but it means you should definitely give her a chance because this is a good girl to date. This is going to be a good girl for you, whether you choose to marry her or whether you choose to, you know, have the relationship run its course. So let's get into the steps right now. Now, if you don't get all of these, that's okay. Remember to work with people, and I would advise you, I would definitely advise you to make sure that you are giving off these things as well too. Number one is going to be she's consistently interested in you. Someone who shows consistent interest in you is the first thing that I look for when I'm trying to decide if I'm going to date somebody. In fact, if they don't show consistent interest in me, I'm probably not going to date them at all. If you're with someone and you're confused, you don't know if she's into you, she's giving you mixed signals, the answer is probably no. So I would go for someone who's giving it to you consistently. And if she's not, find someone who will. Two, she communicates honestly with you. I am all about honest communication. If she can't communicate honestly with you, if she hides her feelings, she lies, these are things that are going to be a problem later on down the line, or these are things that are going to be a problem in the moment as well too. I am open and honest with my communication, and so I lead by example, and if she follows suit, then that's a great person for me to date. If she doesn't do this, I'm not dating her. Three, she has friends. Now, I know this might seem a little bit crazy to a lot of you, but women should have friends, especially female friends. If a woman is with me and she doesn't have a whole lot of female friends or any at all, and she only has guy friends, that's a huge red flag for me. Or if she doesn't have any friends at all, I know I'm gonna be the only person that she's into or talking to, which is gonna make me too much of a responsibility. I don't want that. I want her to have a life. I want her to have other things going on. I want her to have other people that she can talk to. She should have time with the girls. She should have time where she can, you know, talk about me or, you know, just deal with stuff in her own way. That's very important for a woman to have. Okay, and if she doesn't have that, well, then you're gonna be too much of her focus. Four, she has hobbies. If a woman has hobbies, she has things that she likes to do that makes her interesting, that makes her honestly attractive to me, but also it's stuff that she can do, and hopefully you guys can find some hobbies to do together. Okay, with my ex, a lot of the things that we would do is we would do things that we both found fun. There were some things that I didn't do at the beginning that I discovered with her. There were some things that she didn't do at the beginning that she discovered with me, but we always had hobbies that we liked to do. We didn't just go out and drink. We didn't just watch Netflix. We had other things that we liked to do as well too, in our own rights and with each other. Five, she makes time for you. Now, even if she has a very busy schedule, if you're a priority for her, she will make time for you. And you should make time for her as well, too, if she's a priority in your life. Now, the biggest gift a man can give a woman is time and attention. And if you're giving her those things and she's not willing to give that back to you, well, then she's probably not worthy of you giving it to begin with. Six, and I know this might sound a little controversial to some people, but physical attraction. I mean, it should go without saying that you should be physically attracted to the person that you're dating. Now, having said this, physical attraction can change. I remember there's been a lot of women that I've dated in the past where at first I thought they were just cute or maybe they were okay, but once I started to know them a little bit more and saw them in different lights, I'll give you a little secret about women. They don't look the same at all times during the month or at all times during the day, depending on how they feel, depending on what's going on or makeup or whatever it is, okay? People change. And so in a lot of times when I've seen them do certain things, or maybe I see them perform an activity that they're really good at, I got more physically attracted to them. But the physical attraction has to be there. If you've been seeing somebody for a really long time and you just don't find them physically attractive, you gotta find someone who you're going to be that with. Seven. Kind. She's got to be a kind person. If you're with someone and they're not kind to the other people around you, it's only a matter of time before she starts being unkind to you. I'd say in a relationship, if you're with someone for a certain period of time, you really don't see who they are until much farther down the line. It can take months, sometimes even longer for some people, but eventually they will show you their true colors when they come out. And if I see them treating other people in an unkind way, I know eventually that's going to turn to me and I'm going to be that person as well too. Eight. Has goals and ambitions. If she's someone who doesn't have any goals or ambitions, then the only ambition that she's gonna have is you. That's too much responsibility for me. I don't wanna deal with that. And honestly, I think it's sexy when a woman wants to go after something. Now, her ambitions and goals might not be the same as you, so don't judge her based on that, but I like her to go for something. I like her to make stuff happen. I've had women who were very into dance and their ambition was dance and they wanted to become a dancer. Or I had women who just wanted to help people. I had women who were very ambitious monetarily, like they wanted to start a business and make a lot of money. I had other women who wanted to start organizations and just, be a part of the community. But they had something going on. They had an ambition. They had a goal. And if it was with people, if it was relationships or career, it didn't matter. It was something. Number nine, she's stable. You can't be with a girl who is not stable. Okay, now there is going to be some level of instability. There are times when women are going to break down, and that's okay. You have to be there for them. I believe it's your job as the man to be that kind of rock in the relationship. You know, if you're dealing with an unstable person though all the time, it can be impossible for the relationship to be stable if one person never is. So as the guy, I believe we're supposed to be a little bit more stable than the woman that we're with. And when she freaks out, or when she's having some issues, or when she's having problems, depending on when it is, it can be very helpful for the guy to be the more stable person. But if you're always that person, you're always the one who has to, you know, cry on, she's never able to deal with things herself, then you gotta be with somebody who can deal with them yourself, or herself rather. Okay, I am not in the business of fixing women, and you shouldn't be either. Number 10 is she's supportive. She should be supportive of the things that you do. She should be supportive of your lifestyle. She should be supportive of your career. If she's not supportive of those things, she doesn't allow you to go do that, or she doesn't actively take a role and, you know, encourage you and is positive about it, well, then you should probably find someone who is going to be there, because you don't want someone who's going to be a negative in your life. You want somebody who's going to be a positive. And if you've watched my channel at all, you know that the biggest thing that I'm looking for in a woman is someone who can be supportive of me, who's down to go on the path that I'm going down. It doesn't have to be the exact same path, but we can go together and we can end up in almost the same spot. So if you're with someone who is not supportive of you, find someone who will be. And number 11, I don't have 11 fingers, but 11 is takes care of herself, okay? If you see this with a lot of people, maybe they're unkempt, they don't take care of themselves, they don't, like, you know, they're messy. Be a little bit of messy is fine, I'm actually okay with that. But what I'm not okay with is I'm not okay with her taking care of herself, her health, and the people around her. If she can't take care of herself, how well do you think she's gonna take care of you? Okay, that's a reflection of who she is. If she's not taking care of things in her life, well, then you're gonna be one of those things that she doesn't take care of. And I don't know about you, but I wanna be with someone who has their shit together and someone who's responsible. And that comes taking care of themselves. And so you can look at the little things that she does to see if she does that. You know, does she actually shower occasionally? Does she actually clean herself? Does she wear clothes that are appropriate? Does she take care of the things that she does in her life? Okay, if she just leaves things lying around and is super messy and gross and unhygienic, I'm not gonna be with that person. That's just not somebody that I wanna be with. You know, this isn't a college dorm room anymore. I'm an adult. So those are the 11 things, you guys. If you have a girl who has all of these things, definitely, definitely give her a chance. And make sure you are exuding these qualities as well too, because if you're not, it's gonna be very difficult for you to find a girl who is giving you these qualities. So that's the video, you guys. If you made it to end, consider subscribing. I come out with videos like this every single week. If you're interested in getting coached by me or signing up for one of my programs where I teach you how to have these qualities and find women who have these qualities, well, then there's a link in the description box below. Love to see you there. Thanks a lot, you guys. Good luck out there.